You're listening to the Warrior Rulebook Podcast, Episode 2, and today I'm talking about a subject that is near and dear to me, my spirituality. Now, I'm not going to preach to you or quote 1,000 Bible verses, but I do want to share what it really means to be a church girl and why I want God in my life. He has given me the strength to be fearless and made me the warrioress I am today. Ready? Let's talk. You're listening to the Warrior Rulebook Podcast with me, Monique Harmon. I'm a God-fearing, bright fashion blogger, also known as Pretty Neeky, where I share tips on how to activate that part of you that sets your soul on fire to fight whatever life throws at you. Come on, share your story with me. This episode is brought to you by Anchor. It's the easiest way to make a podcast. It gives you everything you need in one place, all for free. You can use their creation tools to allow yourself to record and edit your podcast so they will sound amazing. They'll distribute your podcast for you as well, so it can be heard everywhere on different platforms such as Spotify, Apple Podcasts, and Google Podcasts. You can make money from your podcast with no minimum listenership. Download the Anchor app or go to anchor.fm today to get started. When you were younger, maybe you had the type of parents that made you go to church every Sunday. I had those type of parents, and I've been going to the same church since I was 3 years old. Now, for me, church wasn't boring. I had a blast every time we went. At our church, we had two services. So we had one in the morning, and then we had break, and then we had one in the evening service. It's kind of normal if people that are kind of new to the church don't stay for second service. And so I did used to go through that. Like, my parents would want to leave after first service. And I remember since I was five that I would just cry, like, if I knew that we couldn't stay for second service. I remember one day we were about to leave and I just started crying. And I was like, Dad, I want to stay for second service. And, you know, I was crying for like a good 2 or 3 minutes. And then he was like, okay, well, you need to go upstairs and make sure you're in the service. I was so hyped. Like, I just ran up to the top of the stairs and into service. From then even to now, like, just being in the church on Tuesdays and Thursdays and Sundays is just a surreal experience for me, because like, everything just makes sense. Like, it's fun worshiping God, and of course I learned to sing. We have prayer at first, and then we have singing and testimony service, and then we would sometimes have a program, and then our pastor would preach. And for me, at such a young age, I was able to understand the scriptures, and just hearing my pastor just preach, he backed up everything that he said. So he's always going back to the Bible to support what he is saying. Some preachers, like, they kind of push their own agenda, but my pastor doesn't do that. Like, he's always pushing God in front of us and teaching us the Bible so that we're knowledgeable about what we believe in, and so we can be good servants of God. And so that's really near and dear to my heart. So, like, even when I read inside and outside of church, like, everything just made sense. Like, it just connects to, like, listening to messages and then also just reading on my own. So that's just something that's, like, really close to my heart. Now, growing up in this religion, which is holiness, it was pretty hard because, like, people that asked me about it just didn't, you know what it was. They're like, are you Muslim? Like, are you Catholic? And I was like, no, like, we believe what's in the Bible. We don't twist anything, and everything's really true. And so some people do criticize my pastor because they find him to be controversial, but he's telling the truth. And so sometimes the truth hurts people, and I think that's why sometimes they find it offensive. But it's all out of love, because for me, when I go to the church and even when I'm reading the Bible, like, it's like a mirror. And so, like, you can see yourself in it. Like, it's not for just one class of people, it's for everyone. And so that's what I love about it. That's the beauty of it. And so, like, when I was a kid, I couldn't do certain things. I couldn't wear pants. I couldn't, you know, go on Easter egg hunts or celebrate Halloween. And, like, my friends thought it was weird, and I would explain to them that, like, it was against my religion. And so now, like, I'm accepted for it. And so I am thankful for that aspect. But, like, as a child, just kind of going through that was pretty hard, because I was kind of isolated because I couldn't participate in, like, certain activities that, you know, would condone, you know, Easter egg hunts or Halloween or Christmas and things of that nature. But people in holiness, we still have fun. And that's kind of the message that I want to share today, because we do different things together. We go to movies, we have bonfires, we play different sports. People in the church play different sports. And we just have a really good time. Like, I even started a fashion blog because I wanted to show people that you can wear your own style but still be in the confines of modesty. And so that's just pretty much the message that I want to share with my following, that you can have fun with fashion. And another thing I love about, you know, connecting to God is just the vulnerability that you're allowed to have, because not everybody you can really open up to, but since God knows everything about you, it's safe, you know, to talk to him about it and just kind of like see yourself within the scriptures and, you know, how you can do the right thing. It's kind of like the feeling of like going to the hospital because, like, you know, you're sick, and so you're not really worried about how you look because you already know the doctors are there to save you. And so it's kind of the same thing with going to the church. It's like, even though you might see like different sins or different struggles that you go through, like, it's okay because, like, you know that the pastor or the minister isn't attacking you because it's you. It, like, it's literally just attacking the sin that's in you so you can be a better person. And I have experienced, like, firsthand, like, if I didn't understand a scripture or I like had a problem like within my heart or something like that, and I would just go to church and then I would feel better because like the pastor or the minister would go exactly to the scripture that I had an issue with, or, you know, addressed a feeling that was within me as if they were, had already talked to me, and they didn't. So like, just to experience that, and a lot of people in my church have actually experienced that as well, is not unsettling at all. It's very helpful, and it's very comforting knowing that God is listening. The word of God doesn't only tell you like the wrong things that you're doing, it's also there as an encouragement as well. And there are a few sermons that we listen to and we hear, and it's like God's encouraging you to put your best foot forward. And we learn a different range of topics, like anything from like relationships to being more invested in God to, you know, having a good conduct in the church. So it's like, it's a different range of topics that we learn in the church, and they apply to our daily life. So like, it's very helpful to be in that environment. When you're like growing up in holiness, it kind of seems, or just growing up religious in general, people are waiting for you to make a mistake. And it's not everyone, but certain people are like, they're waiting for you to fall. And by that I mean, like, if I did something wrong in school, or, you know, I just did something, like made a mistake, and then somebody be like, oh, you're a church girl, you're not supposed to do that. But it's like, well, we all have a moral code. So if somebody else did the same exact thing and it was wrong, like, they would be wrong as well. But I think some people may hold people that are in the church like to this high standard as if we're perfect, and we're not. Like, we're trying to achieve that perfection. And as a child, I did not, you know, have all the tools. I didn't understand everything. Like, I did understand a lot of things as a child, you know, by going to church constantly and, you know, reading the word and things of that nature. But certain lessons you learn when you get older. And so I just think being held to that standard that I had to be perfect was a little harsh. And so, like, now, even now, I'm still learning. Like, I'm not perfect. Like, I'm still trying to reach that standard of perfection. So it's definitely a process. And, you know, we're very real in our church. So, like, we know, like, that everybody's going to make mistakes. And it's not to use it as a comfort blanket or, like, a scapegoat or something of that nature. But it's just more so it's being aware that we're human and that we're trying to achieve that level of perfection. So we are encouraged not to judge anybody because we have to work on ourselves. And also, like, just as a result of going to church since I was 3 and like really being invested in it, I can definitely say that I have a stronger bond with God. And that comes through like listening to messages that are recorded on YouTube. Like, our church records messages on YouTube, and reading the scriptures every day, and just, you know, being active in church and knowing that all the work that we're doing in the church is for God. And so, like, when you love the Lord, like, you will, you know, work really hard to like make sure that you get everything done. And so it's like, and you don't mind it. Like, it could be hard, it could keep you up late at night, but it's just kind of like with our natural job, like, if you want something, you have to work for it. And so that's my reasoning for that. And also, we're taught like in the church that, you know, we have to be invested in God for ourselves. Like, we can't just be into church or just be into our religion just because somebody like is forcing us to. Of course, like when we're children and our parents go to church, they're gonna make us go to church. But like when you get to a certain age, you have to like realize, like, I want to spend the rest of my life with God. I want God to be in all of my decision making because he has the best plan. And so it's just a comfort to, you know, talk to him and believe in him. And sometimes it's hard, I'm not gonna lie. I'm not gonna say, you know, it's always easy, because it's not. But just knowing that somebody is up there watching out for you is just very helpful. So it's like, even when you lose a sense of direction, like, you can just go and pray, you can just talk about it, and God is not going to judge you, you know, for the decisions that you made, as long as it doesn't like contradict him. But it's just really helpful just to talk to him and like even vent sometimes, and also just thank him like for everything that he's done. Like, I don't think that prayer should just be, you know, a complaining place. Like, you should definitely, you know, thank God for where you came from and, you know, how he continues to bless you even in despite of the things that go wrong. So I definitely think that talking to him and thanking him and being appreciative definitely helps your relationship with God. And it's like with any relationship, like, you have to work hard for it to like maintain it, because, you know, life happens, things happen, and you just kind of want to make sure that you're consistent so you can get the best out of that relationship. And so, and God is actually, he's very helpful. So, you know, he'll, you know, bless you on his own will and just kind of help you every step of the way. Like, even when you, like I said before, like, even when you feel lost, like, you just go to him and you just talk. And you might not be able to talk to somebody else about it, but you have him. So it definitely taught me, you know, to pray more and to believe in God more, especially like when people that you go to don't understand you. Because I don't even understand a lot of things that people come to me with, but I just try to be that supportive ear. Another common question I would get when I was in school, some of the students would be like, oh, are you gonna still wear skirts when you're grown, and are you still gonna be in this religion when you were grown? And I, you know, and you know, when you get that question, sometimes you're like, well, am I going to be? And I was like, I want to say I was like 96% sure at that age, like, that I was going to stay in it. And I'm still thankful that I'm in it. So just like to remember that and just still know that I'm still like striving to be holy. And so, yeah, that is pretty much my spiritual background on just like how I'm able to be bright when I am and just be, you know, happy and focused like I am, because I have him to thank for helping me. So now I want to hear from you guys. What does spirituality do for you? If you could leave a comment and a review of this podcast, that would be very helpful. I do want to hear from you and keep the conversation going. Thanks, guys. Bye. Thank you so much for tuning in to the Warrior Rulebook podcast. If you like what you heard, share it with a friend and join me over at the Warrior Rulebook Podcast Insider Group on Facebook. And don't forget to follow me on Facebook, Instagram, and Twitter for more tips on how to be resilient in this world.